Hey, what's going on YouTube? Today I'm going to show you a recommendation system. This is a project that I got from the Freed Code Camp course. I'll leave a link in the description, but it's a good way to use recurrent neural networks to recommend books. So part of the code was already filled out for me, and then other parts of the code I wrote myself, along with the help of other folks on the internet where in places where I got stuck. But I thought it was a good starting point because recommendation systems are so prevalent in our technological society these days. So let's go ahead and run through the code and I'll show you what a recommendation system looks like. We're gonna import the usual suspects here, NumPy, pandas, sparse CSR matrix. It's not really a usual suspect, but you'll see how we use them later. We're going to do the nearest neighbors and matplotlib for plotting our data. So let's go ahead, get those guys in here. And like I said, I got this from Free Code Camp. This is their project. They have a data file called book crossings, which is just a CV of a bunch of books as well as ratings in those books too. So let's go ahead and download that, get that into our system here. Then we're going to create two data frames, one for books and one for ratings. You can see what is basically the how we're going to create that data frame and the ratings here. And then we're going to merge those two data frames. And in the end, we should have something that looks like this. So we'll have the user, the person who rated the book, the book ISBN, the rating, the title, and the author. And as you can see here, it looks like we've got about 1.15 million rows and then 5 columns here. So pretty decent amount of data. In this, we're counting the users in the data frame as well as the ISBN. And as long as they're greater than 200, so we just want the users that have left more than 200 reviews, and we want books that have more than 100 reviews. That gives us enough statistical relevance on those specific books and ratings and users that will actually make a difference. So we don't want a book that has like one rating, or we don't want to include users that have only rated like 2 books, because that isn't really statistically significant for recommending books based on a new data point. If you have an understanding of what nearest neighbors does, you're basically saying like, okay, this new data point in our plot here is closest to this grouping, or closest to this grouping, or closest to this grouping. And that's how it's able to recommend the other data points surrounding that new data point. So now that we've sparsed out the statistically insignificant, we're going to recreate our new data frame that's, you know, assigned to these users here, and we're going to drop duplicates. We're going to see if there's any missing in the frame, and we see that title, there's 238 title and authors, so we're just going to drop those, because 238, if you think about it, out of, you know, 1 million plus, it's not going to make much of a difference. So if we look at our shape now, after we've removed all those users that were going to skew our data and got rid of the missing values, we're left with 49,103. So we got rid of quite a lot, but it's still a good thing because we can really only train models where the data has significant clusterings. So when we have a lot of sparsed out clusterings, it's going to stretch where our model fits and sparses out where those nearest neighbors are. So we want it to be congested in certain parts so that we can get clear recommendations. This is what it looks like in a pivot table. We've sort of transposed the user, and the title would go is here on the index side, and the users up here, and these are the ratings. That just helps us create a matrix And this is where the CSR matrix comes into play. And it's nice to put it in a matrix because then we can fit it to our nearest neighbors model. So we'll just assign the variable NN and activate the nearest neighbors function here with the metric of cosine. I went through and tried a bunch of different other metrics to use. Cosine is certainly the one to use. And then we're going to fit it to the matrix that we just created up here. This function, I think, is pretty well outlined. It's a function that returns the recommended books. And so as you can see, we're going to pass in a string that's going to equal our book. And what we're doing here is initializing the book and then an empty list that we're going to fill in based on the distance that the model finds given our string input. So as you can see, we're gonna collect the distance and the book info from our model based on a pivot table and gather the text and distance and reverse the order. That's just to make it easier to read. And so for each value in our two variables, append to our empty book list above. Yeah, we're gonna zip it together, put it in that empty list. So this function will make more sense once we run it. So let's take a book like Catcher in the Rye. It's going to return Tis a Memoir, Angela's Ashes, Their Eyes Were Watching God, 1984, To Kill a Mockingbird. That's, you know, and these numbers here are essentially the distance. So the higher this number is, the closer it is to a recommendation. So you can see that this one's 78. So this one is like the, in the eyes of this model, is the one closest to Catcher in the Rye. So when we try Where's the Heart Is, Oprah's Book Club, this is where the code, Free Code Camp, decides whether or not I passed it. And I believe I do pass it. Yeah, I do pass it. Okay, great. So then once we try Where the Heart Is, which is part of Oprah's Book Club, paperback edition, it goes in and it tests our get recommendations function basically in this function, and it evaluates whether or not the book distance that is passed back is at least 80% here, 77% here. So if we look, I'll Be Seeing You, that's 80%. The Weight of the Water is 77. Surgeon, 76. I Know This Much Is True, 76. Lovely Bones, 72. So those are pretty good metrics. And I guess this is how the recommendation works. So let's say we don't want to try a Catcher in the Rye. Let's try 1984, see what it gives us. Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, Slaughterhouse-Five. Catcher in the Rye, Animal Farm, Handmaid's Tale. So dystopian science fiction books plus, you know, classic, another book by George Orwell and another classic there. So that makes sense. Let's try. I don't know if this will be in there. Whoops. I think this is the title of the book. I'm thinking of, oh, what is going on with my keyboard? I need a new keyboard or something. Let's try that. Okay, so that book wasn't in the, it wasn't in the list there. That's a really good autobiography of a surgeon who ends up getting a brain tumor and then writes about his experience. Excellent book. What's another book? Let's just do like Lord of the Rings. Is that not in there either? Nope. Okay. So, wow. I just put in like a ton of different books, but none of them were in there. That's kind of dumb. All right. So that was a pretty quick video. I just wanted to show you guys how basically it works. And it's a good tutorial. If the definitely the Free Code Camp is a challenge for sure. But it was really, really good exercise and creating a recommendation system. I'd like to do it with basically other data too. So maybe stay tuned and see what other kind of, I'd like to make it with movies. So I think I might tinker around with this notebook and see if I can just plug in film data and see if I can build my own film recommendation. I'll leave it there. So I hope everyone has a good time and I'll see you later. Bye.